we want to place one set of absolute value symbols in each inequality below to make the inequality true. Notice how right now the expression on the left and the expression on the right are exactly the same, so they're actually equal. We want the left side to be less than the right side for this first inequality, and the second inequality we want the left side to be greater than the right side. Let's begin by simplifying both sides of the inequality. So looking at our expressions, we first simplify the exponents. Well, 4 to the third is equal to 4 times 4 times 4, which equals 64. So this simplifies to negative 6 times 3 minus 64. And of course, the same on the right. Next, we multiply and divide before we add or subtract. So the next step is to find this product. Well, negative 6 times 3 is equal to negative 18. So we have negative 18 minus 64, again on both sides. And then finally subtracting, negative 18 minus 64 is equal to negative 82. So again, we want the left side to be less than the right side. We know negative numbers are always less than positive numbers, which means if we were to include the right side of this inequality in a set of absolute value symbols here, when simplifying, it would look like this. Notice for our last step, we would have the absolute value of negative 82, which is positive 82, which would make this inequality true. We'd have negative 82 is less than positive 82, which is true. Now for the second inequality, the only difference is we now have a greater than symbol here. So now we want the right side to be greater than the left side. And again, these are the same expressions which simplify to negative 82. So if we want the right side to be greater now, we can just include the right side in the set of absolute value symbols. Notice by doing this, when simplifying, we'd have positive 82 is greater than negative 82, which is true. Remember, with an inequality symbol, it always points toward the smaller number and opens toward the larger number. I hope you found this helpful.